us this morning? Y'all are so loud. I could hear you. Let's see how loud you can be. Ready? On the count of three. One, two, three. Wow. That's really loud. Really loud. All right. Well, I am so excited for you guys to be here today, and we are going to get started in just a second. But before we get started, we've got to go over just a couple of things, all right? Are y'all ready?
Welcome, everybody. Thank you for being here today. I'm Fernando, the great, fantastico, the world's greatest magician. How are you, sir? Oh, what is this behind your ear? Oh, it's a quarter. Oh, thank you. I will keep that for myself. Oh, thank you for being here today. Oh, look at these lovely young small people. Well, so good to see you all here. Thank you for being here today. I am glad to be here.
Excuse me? What did you say your name was?
My name is Fernando. The Fantastico.
Fernando the Fantastico.
No. Fernando.
Everybody say Fernando.
Trill your tongue.
I can't.
Fernando.
Fernando. I can't do it.
Say that with me. Say fur.
I can't do it. Fur.
Fernando.
Okay, Fernando. Yes. Anyway, what are you doing here?
I'm the world's greatest magician. I am traveling around the country, and I am doing my magics for everybody. Well, you want to see some magic?
No, you're interrupting. We're about to get ready to start Cornerstone Kids Live, and you're having trouble there, aren't you?
My mustache.
Yes, look at
it. It is so long and beautiful. It tends to fall off of my face sometimes.
It is long. No. We don't have time for any magic tricks this morning.
Oh,
no.
But the children have time, don't you, children? Yes, they want to see my magic because my magic is so magical.
Okay, you can do one trick. Go ahead.
Just one trick.
We'll see. It depends on how good this trick is.
To do just one trick. Well, what I'm going to do for you right now is I'm going to do a magic trick just between me and you.
Just me and you.
Now, I have this deck of cards right here. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm going to read your mind. Yes, I am. Because I'm going to have you pick a card.
Okay.
Any card? Oh, excuse me. How embarrassing. You know what we just do without it? How's that sound? Pick a card, any card.
Okay.
Don't let me see it, though,
I got
okay?
It. I'm not.
Do not let me see it.
Can I show the kids?
Well, yes, if you want to, but I'm going to close my eyes so I do not see it, okay?
Don't say it. Shh.
All right. Do you have it?
I have
it. You know what it is?
I know what it is.
You can see it in your mind even if you don't see it with your face?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Now, put it back in here. All right. Now, I move my hands. So I will even shuffle the cards.
Wow.
Whoa. So
that
you know that I'm not doing any tricks, okay?
Okay?
Now, are you ready?
I'm ready.
I show you the card that you picked. Abracadabra, Alakazoo. I'm going to show you the card that you picked right here. Is this your card?
Wow, that is our card.
Oh,
that is our card.
Is that your card? Check it
that,
for me.
That is our card.
Make
that
sure
is
no
pretty
tricks.
Good.
That's right. All right.
I was pretty impressed.
Thank you. Whoa. Oh, see.
Hey.
Oh, you see nothing.
Hey, wait
you
a minute.
You see nothing, okay?
Those are all ace of spades. Okay.
Oh, that's not important, okay?
That was
just a little detail.
Trick. That was
now,
a lousy trick.
Wait, I've got another trick.
No, I think that
was. You want to see another trick? Yes.
Okay.
Now, for this one, I'm going to need someone from the audience. Let's see if I can pick somebody in the audience. Who shall I pick? Oh, maybe this one right here. I'm not sure she has to go to the bathroom or what. But come on up here. All right.
All right.
Now, what is your name? Brooke. Her name is Brooke. Brooke, do you know me? Have we ever met before? Excuse me. No, my name is Fernando. Okay, it's not important. All right. Now, should I pick somebody else? No, okay. All right, what is your name? Brooke.
Brooke.
She forgot already. It's not going so well. All right, Brooke. Now, I noticed something, Brooke. You look like you got a little booger in your nose. Maybe you should run and catch it.
What?
No, wait. That's not right. It looked like your nose is running. Maybe you should go catch.
Oh, yeah. Well, that.
No,
yeah,
I'm bad. Sorry.
That's bad.
My jokes, they're not so good.
No.
Okay, now, Brooke, your nose is running, though. Do you have a handkerchief? Maybe you need a handkerchief. You not have a handkerchief on you? No? Oh, look, I have one here. Why don't you take this handkerchief? Yeah. Brooke, what are you doing? Stop. Oh, that will not do. That will not work. We need another handkerchief. Wait, let's see if I've got one somewhere. I know I've got one in one of my pockets. Let's see. It was nothing in this. Oh, this right here. There, we've got a handkerchief. You see this? What color is this handkerchief, Brooke?
Red.
She says that it is red. Do you agree with her that this handkerchief is red? Is this handkerchief red? She says it is, but I say that this handkerchief is whatever color it wants to be. She says it's red, but when I pull it out over here, what color? Brooke, what color is the handkerchief?
Yellow.
She says it is yellow. She is right. Is she right?
Yeah.
Boys and girls, is she right? Yes, she is, because it is yellow. Oh, now, Brooke, I ask you, is it really yellow?
Yes.
Or is it some other color? Because I say again that it is whatever color it wants to be. Brooke, what color is it going in?
Yellow.
And what color do you think it's going to be when I pull it out?
Green.
She says green. She is
Whoa.
Amazingly correct. Have you done this trick before, Brooke? Never. Oh, my goodness. So it is green. Now, what color did we start with?
Red.
We started with red. But now we have a green handkerchief. So we need to get back to red, do we? Do we need to get back to red? Well, let's put it back in and see if we can get to turn back to red. And yes, we did it!
Wow.
Oh, look at the magic. Because I have magic hands, right? Yes. You people don't seem too amused or amazed. You should be amazed.
Very.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Brooke, thank you very much for your help. You may be seated. You're taking all of my glory.
That was okay. I've seen that before.
Okay.
And I think
Can
I know
you
how
change the color of a handkerchief just by using your hands?
I think I know how you do it.
Do
so
you?
It's not very impressive. I don't know. I just think.
But wait, I have more magics.
Okay.
Yes, I do. I can even make things float in the air.
You can make stuff float.
Do you want
in
to see me float things in
okay,
the
well,
air?
Okay, well, wait a minute. You know, we've got a whole service to go through. So I tell you what, if you can really make things float, if you'll hang out with us for about 30 minutes or so.
If I can really.
If.
You don't believe? Don't you want to taste of the glory? Just to see what it tastes like.
No. If you will hang out with us for about 30 minutes, then we'll let you come back out at the end and make something float. How does that sound?
Fernando the Fantastico is not used to waiting.
Oh, well, so sorry, yo.
If the
You're
kids want to see some great magic, I will wait. Do you want to see some great magic?
You guys want to see it? Okay.
Yes, okay. Then I shall return.
All right.
I will be back later, and you will see some of my greatest feats. Yes?
I'm so sorry about that, guys. That was so unexpected. I am really sorry that he came out, but if he can make something float, I'm kind of looking forward to seeing that. How about you? Yeah? All right, like I was saying before he came in, before we get started tonight, there's just a few things we need to go over. We have just a few rules that if you will follow these rules tonight, you will have a fun time. So we're going to go over those real quick. Are you ready? Oh, hey, Limey.
Hello, Miss Erin.
Hey, Limey.
Can you hear me?
No, we can't.
What?
You gotta get louder.
What about now?
Nope.
What about now?
Is it better? Can y'all hear him?
Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now?
We can hear you. We can hear you.
Can you hear me now?
Limey, we can hear you.
Oh, okay.
Okay. All right.
Hey, I am here and I am so excited because it's Cornerstone Kids Alive.
I know.
Oh, I'm just green with envy. Oh, Miss Sarah, okay. No, wait. I even heard that we have a real life magician here.
We do. We do. He wasn't supposed to be here, but he's here.
I like magicians. I love watching them do their magic. Now, I even heard that he can make things float in the air. Is that true?
That's what he said. He said he can make things float. So we're going to see here in a little bit.
Oh, I hope he can do it because I hope he'll make me float in the air because I've always wanted to fly like Superman.
Oh, I don't know. Maybe he'll pick you, Limey, okay?
Oh, yeah.
But real quick, we're going to go over our rules. I told the boys and girls we've got just a few rules. And I know you are in Kids Zone almost every week. And you know the rules back there. So
can you tell them? I'm like the back of my right hand.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Where is your right hand?
Hey.
Mm-hmm.
Don't make fun of me, okay? Just because I got one hand.
Okay. All right. So tell them what rule number one is.
Oh, yeah. Rule number one, boys and girls, has to do with this finger right here.
This one right here. Everybody go like this. This finger.
Go like this.
Rule number one.
This is a very important rule, okay?
Mm-hmm.
You never...
Never.
No matter how many times somebody asks you.
Nope.
Never pull this finger right here.
Wait a minute. Limey, that's not a rule in Kid Zone.
Pull my finger, Miss Erin.
No.
I've got a magic trick of my own. Pull my finger, Miss Erin.
Yeah, I don't want to see that magic trick. No, that
Come
is
on,
not.
Come on, do it.
No.
Everybody's pulling my finger. Oh, okay.
Rule number one, boys and girls, is no talking unless you're supposed to. Because we want you to hear everything that's going on the stage. And if you're talking, you can't hear. Right, Limey?
That is so
true. That's right.
And you know what?
What?
If you're pulling somebody's finger, you're hearing something else that you probably don't want to hear.
That's true. That is true. Mm-hmm. Rule number two.
Well, let's see. Rule number two. I can get this one, Miss Erin.
Okay.
I can get it. Wait. What is it? Oh, yeah.
You got it. You know it. What is it?
It is. If you sprinkle, this is for the boys.
It's for the boys.
If you sprinkle when you tinkle, be a sweetie and wipe the seedy.
Limey.
Okay?
I like that rule. That's a pretty good one. That is not a rule in Kid Zone.
Oh, it's not?
No.
And all the boys say, freedom!
Oh, Limey.
Oh, yeah.
That Woo-hoo! Is gross. All right, rule number two, guys, since he's not getting it right, are keep your hands and feet to yourself. Don't be messing with your neighbor. And I guess keep your tinkle to yourself, too, Limey, okay? I don't know.
Miss Erin.
Hey.
That is gross.
You said it.
You are so... you're embarrassing
Limey,
me. In front of all these adults.
Limey, rule number three. Just get one rule right.
Oh.
Make us look good, okay? One rule. Just one rule. You can do it.
I can do this, Miss Erin. Do you believe in me?
Sort of.
Okay, wait.
Yes.
Let me think. So much pressure.
You can
stay off the stage and in your seat.
Yes. Stay off the stage and in your seat.
Yeah, I got it right, Miss Erin.
I am so impressed.
Yes. Oh yeah. Woo. Go, Limey.
Go, Limey. Hey, Limey. You know what?
Limey.
I'm gonna give you a piece of candy.
Because
candy? You got a rule right. Yeah. Wait a minute.
I love candy, Miss Erin.
Oh, Limey, I forgot to bring the candy bucket out. Can you go get it for me?
Oh, man, I'm not going to get a piece of candy.
Yeah, it's right back there. Can you just get it for me?
Oh, yeah.
Right behind you.
Where is it, Miss Erin? Where is it?
It's right there.
Right where?
Right behind you.
Miss Erin?
Limey?
I don't see anything.
It's right behind you. Right back there. I said it right back there.
Well, Miss Erin.
What?
It's gone.
Limey, it was back...
But it's not there now.
Did you eat it?
Miss Erin, how can you say such a thing?
Because you have before.
Oh, yeah, I know I have before, but no, I didn't it this time.
You did not eat it.
I promise.
Okay.
Pinky swear. Yeah,
right.
I did not eat the candy. I mean, there's a chalk outline where the box was.
All right.
It's missing, Miss Erin.
Okay, well, boys
this
and girls.
This is horrible. I'm not going to get my candy.
Yes, you are. I'm going to... Limey, stop. Limey.
I just want a piece of candy.
Limey, stop. I'm going to come back there and help you find it. All right, boys and girls, I'm going to have to go help Limey find the candy. I need you to stand up and get ready to praise the Lord, okay?
3, 2, 1.
What happened? What happened? Just go to the next song.
always gonna be there. Yeah, you're always gonna be there. When I'm in danger, when I'm in trouble, when I'm surrounded, when I know that it's you that I can count on, that I can always count on. Hear me shout it out.
You guys did awesome. All right, we're going to go over our memory verse, and we're going to have this memory verse today, tonight, and tomorrow night. It's an easy memory verse, so I'm going to say it, and I want you guys to say it after me. Can y'all do that? Yeah? Are you ready? All right. The thief's purpose is to steal and kill and destroy. My purpose is to give them a rich and satisfying life. John 10:10. That was good, but I think you can do it a lot louder. Can you guys get loud? Yeah. Are you sure? Show me how loud you can get. Can y'all get loud? Yeah. All right, I want you to say it really loud. Say it after me. Are you ready? The thief's purpose, say it, is to steal and kill and destroy. My purpose is to give them a rich and satisfying life. Very good. Oh, John 10:10. What are y'all yelling at? What? What are you yelling? Where did that word go? I don't even remember what the word was. Do you guys? Thieves? Okay, let's see. Stand up. You're going to have to stand up because y'all are just like sitting there like this. I need you to like help me here, all right? Are you ready? Say it after me. The thief's purpose is to steal and kill. Say it with me. And destroy. My purpose is to give them a rich and satisfying life. John 10:10. What are you girls yelling at? What? Oh, why are y'all not warning me? You're not even warning me. No, you're not. Okay, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter because you know what? We can say it without that word. Now, what was that word? Sad. That's right. All right. All right. I think I got it. What was the first word? Thieves. What was that last word? Okay, we got it. Say it after me. The thief's purpose is to steal and kill and destroy. I know you guys are excited, but say the verse with me. Go back to your seats. What are you saying? I give up. Y'all aren't even trying to say it. You're just like pointing at what? Why did you guys not warn me? No, you didn't. Okay, what was it? I don't even know what word it was. steal, and y'all didn't even warn me that somebody's stealing my word. All right, I'm going over to this side because this side might work with me a little better. Are y'all going to help me a little better? They're not even warning me over here. All right, say it with me. The thief's purpose is to steal and kill and destroy. Say it with me. What are you yelling at? What? Where? Where? Y'all didn't even warn me. What? All right, guys, have a seat. Have a seat. Have a seat. All right. There's four words. Was he in there? He was. Oh, I don't know. Okay, I need you guys to say it with me. Are you ready? There's four words missing, and I don't know. I think I'm going to need your help because I don't think I can say it by myself. So I want you to stand up. Say it with me this time on the count of three. Ready? One, two, three. The thief's purpose is to steal and to kill and destroy. My purpose is to give them a rich and satisfying life. John 10:10. Very good. You guys can have a seat. Thanks a lot for warning me. Y'all didn't warn me very well, but you guys did awesome. And we're going to say this memory verse again tonight and again Monday night. And by the end of that, you guys are going to have it, all right? All right. Are you ready for the Bible story? Yes. Guess what?
Miss Erin.
Oh, I have somebody special coming to help me.
Is that my cue? Is that me, Miss Erin?
That's your cue.
Is it time for the Bible story already?
And Limey's going to tell us a Bible story about a man in the Bible who actually thought that God was the one stealing from him. How many of you know God's not a thief?
No.
God doesn't steal, but this man thought he was, so we're going to learn about him real quick.
Yeah.
All right, Limey.
But Miss Erin, before I tell this story,
okay,
I have some very special props that I'm going to get
okay.
so that I can use them to tell this story.
Okay.
Hang on, let me go grab them real quick.
You need help? What? Do you need help?
Miss Erin?
What?
Did you take my props?
I didn't take your props. Did y'all take his props?
Yeah.
I think some of them are joking.
I just had them back here a moment ago, now they're missing.
Limey, you know what? We have a lot of missing stuff today. First, the candy. We never found the candy, by the way.
Oh, I forgot. I want my candy.
Okay. No, don't start that again. The candy. And then a song was missing earlier. We couldn't even do our first song. And then four of the memory verse words were missing, Limey.
You're kidding
me. No. And now your props, you're just going to have to tell the Bible story without them.
Miss Erin, I can't.
You have to.
I worked so hard doing it with these props. And now I can't do it without the props.
You're going to have to.
Oh, it's over, Miss Erin.
Limey, pull yourself together.
Cornerstone Kids, life is over.
Limey.
Kids, you might as well just
Limey,
go home.
Look at me.
Bye.
Limey.
Oh.
Limey.
What?
Pull yourself together. We've got a lot of people out here. Tell the Bible story.
I know. There's a bunch of people
you
out here.
You can do it.
And they're here waiting on me to tell this Bible
That's
story
right.
with my props. And now I don't have them.
Limey, tell the Bible story. You can do it without the props. You can do it.
All right, I'll try, Miss Erin.
All right, you can do it.
I'll do my best. Okay.
All right.
Boys and girls, are you ready?
Are y'all ready? All right.
Now. Once upon a time, that's how every good story starts.
That is true.
Once upon a time, there was a man. His name was Job. And Job
Job.
What?
Job. His name was Job.
Oh.
Yeah, Job.
See, if I had my props, Miss Erin, I would have got that right.
Oh, okay.
So there was a man named Job. And God had blessed him with all kinds of things. He had a big family. He had a really big house, he had a nice luxury car.
He had
lots of sheep and a big swimming pool.
Okay. Well, he had a lot of stuff. He had been blessed.
So he was blessed.
He was.
But then that big bad devil, he came along and he came up and he knocked on Job's door and he said, Little pig,
wait.
Let me in, or I will huff,
Limey.
And I will puff, and I will blow your house in. And Job said, not by the hair of my chinny-chin-chin.
Limey, no. That is not the story of Job. That is the three little pigs. Just never mind. I'm going to tell the story. I'll tell
no,
you.
No, wait. Miss Erin.
What?
That's horrible. Nobody wants you to tell this story.
Limey? Then get it right.
Okay.
Get it right.
Okay, it's because I don't have my props.
Oh, okay. The big right. bad devil did come.
Okay, so the big bad devil,
he
came.
From Job.
And he started taking stuff away from Job. Because he saw how much Job had been blessed with, and he didn't like it. And so he started taking stuff from him. He started taking it this way and that way, and he took it all away.
That's right.
And Job was suddenly missing so many things. And then some of Job's friends came along. He had three friends that walked up to him, and they said, Job, what have you done? You must have done something really bad against God because he's taken all your stuff away. They started trying to get him to blame God.
That's right.
The first one, he said, Job, what did you do? Did you make your porridge too hot? And the second one said, Job, what happened, man? Did you make your porridge too cold?
What?
And the third one said, Job, because you made your porridge too hot, and you made your porridge too cold.
Limey.
God is spitting you out of his mouth,
okay.
Man.
Limey,
I mean, he
no,
can't stand
stop.
You.
Limey, stop. That
what?
Is not the way the story of Job goes. That is Goldilocks and the Three Bears. I am. That's it. I'm taking over. You are not doing it right. Yes, I'm taking over.
Wait.
What?
Wait. Listen. Look into my eyes.
No.
You are getting sleepy.
No, I'm not. I'm taking
you
over.
You are not taking over.
Yes,
You're
I am.
You're going to let me finish.
No.
Come on, one more chance.
No, no more chances.
Come on, one more chance.
No more chances.
One more chance.
Limey.
One more chance.
Okay.
Two more chances.
One.
Two more.
One.
Okay.
One.
Okay, one more chance. Okay.
One.
That's all I need.
One more chance.
I can do this.
Get it right.
I can get this right. So, Job had a lot of stuff. The big bad devil came and took it away, and his friends tried to get him to blame God. And Job started believing them. But God spoke to Job, and he said, I didn't take your stuff.
That's right.
This was the devil that took it. And Job listened to God, and he realized that it was not God that was taking all of his stuff.
That's right.
But it was the devil that took it away. And he asked God to forgive him for even thinking that God would take things away from him. And so once he repented, God started restoring him and he started blessing him with even more stuff than he had before. Oh, the end.
He got a little bit right. That was awesome. Give him a hand.
Ooh, thank you. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I did it, Miss Erin.
A little bit of it.
Miss Erin.
What?
I just realized something.
What?
Job was not missing anything in his life until the devil showed up.
That's right. And it wasn't until the devil came that he lost all of his stuff.
Yeah.
That's right, because he's the thief.
Miss Erin.
What?
We weren't missing anything today until that magician showed up.
Limey, you can't.
What?
Now, that's some pretty serious accusations. You cannot accuse him of stealing our stuff.
But
we do not know that.
I'm not accusing him. I'm just saying that he did it.
Yeah, that's accusing him. You can't do that. You can't go around calling somebody
a thief
if you
Miss
don't
Erin.
Know. You got to have proof.
Are you telling me that there's not something fishy going on around here ever since that magician showed up?
A little bit, yes. And I've kind of thought that too. But, you know, we're not we just can't accuse him of that.
Hmm.
We can't without proof. We don't have any proof of that.
It seems to me that I need to do a little bit of investigating.
No, you don't. Like,
and I will find us the very proof that we need. Let me go back here. Oh, I'm going to look around.
Get up here.
Nope. Don't stop me, Miss Erin.
Limey, get up here.
Oh, what was that?
What?
I ran into something. Okay. Oh, I stubbed my toe.
Limey, get up here.
What is this? Miss Erin, I found something. Wait.
What did you find?
Turn the other way. Wait. Wait, let's see. Oh, it's heavy, Miss Erin.
Limey.
Oh, can you help me?
No, I am not helping you with that. Limey, that is the magician's trunk.
Yeah, look at
that, Miss Erin.
What
are you doing with that?
What?
That is the magician's trunk. You can't.
Oh, you're right. It is the magician's trunk. Yeah. And look, Miss Erin, look,
what?
It's already unlocked.
It Limey, it was not unlocked. Do not touch that. Do not open it. You, that is somebody else's property.
I'm not doing anything.
You do not open it. Wait. Don't touch it.
Oh, I'm really tired, Miss Erin.
Limey? Limey.
Oh, look at that.
It's our memory verse words.
Oh, there
and
they
are.
And
our song. Here's our missing song.
Oh.
Oh, my goodness, Limey. Here's all the candy you were looking for.
Oh, there's my candy.
Wait a minute.
Miss Erin, wait. You still owe me a piece of candy.
Wait, what's this?
Miss Erin, that's my props.
Captain America is your prop?
Yeah, you're holding Job in your hand as we speak.
That's, okay. Limey.
Ugh.
I have to say, even though you should not have opened that, you were right.
How did that word feel coming out of your mouth,
Miss
Erin? Pretty bad.
Pretty bad. Really bad.
Did you like throw up a little bit?
A little bit in the back of my mouth. Yeah, a little bit. Yeah.
Wow.
All right. Well, Limey, I don't know what to do because, you know, I already told him he could come out and do his tricks. Like, I don't know. We just can't.
Miss Erin?
What?
I was the one that found out and investigated and found all of our props and everything that was been missing.
Yeah.
So I feel it is my obligation to see this through to the end. I must go confront this magician
right now,
Miss Erin.
Limey, I don't think that's a good idea.
Oh, you can't stop me. Don't try to hold me back, Miss Erin. I'm a fighter.
Limey,
and a lover.
Listen to me.
Oh, yeah, I can take him down. Woo, these girls are waiting on me to go take care of this.
Limey.
I'm going to go take him down, Miss Erin. You can't stop me.
Wait a minute. Limey, listen to me. Just tell him that I want to see him on the stage and don't say anything else to him, okay?
Okay.
All right, guys. You know what? Limey said something really interesting. He said that it wasn't until the devil showed up that Job was missing his stuff. Have you guys ever been missing stuff? I don't mean like a pencil at school or anything. I mean, have you ever been missing joy in your life? How many of you have ever been missing health? Maybe you've been sick. Did you know that it is not God that makes you sick, that it's not God that takes your joy away? Because God's not a thief. Who did we learn today is the thief? The devil. If you're missing something, it's the devil. And you know what? Job finally realized that, and he decided, enough's enough. I'm not letting him take away anything else from me. And he stood up, and he began to thank God, and he began to realize that God was the one that was good to him. And he began to believe in God again. And what did God do? God blessed him with even more than he had before. Because you know what, guys? Everybody say this after me. Say, God good, devil bad. Say it again. Say, God good, devil bad. Say it like this. Say, God good, devil bad.
Some of my greatest magic tricks is making facial hair disappear off of my face right in front of everybody.
That's impressive. That
yes.
is. Well.
Yes. Well, what is this? There's some green puppet came back here and said that you were needing me on stage. Are you ready for my magic tricks?
We are. Shh.
Are you ready for my magic tricks?
We're ready.
I have saved my best tricks for last. Yes. Are you
yes.
ready? I have in my pocket what appears to be just an ordinary piece of plastic. But this is no ordinary piece of plastic. This is what I call Mr. Plastic. I can control him with my mind.
With your mind.
Yes.
This should be good.
Are you ready to
We're
watch
ready.
Me manipulate Mr. Plastic with my mind?
We are. Y'all ready?
Yeah.
You gotta watch close. Watch closely.
Oh, yes.
Ooh.
Look at this. Mm. And I bring him back to me like this. And then I push him. Oh, and then I pull Mr. Plastic back. Push him. And I pull him back. Yeah. Shut up.
Oh, wow.
Thank you very much.
Oh.
Thank you.
Wow.
Yes, one of my greatest tricks right there. Mm-hmm. Thank you very much.
That was pretty good.
Mr. Plastic,
good.
Stop. You're embarrassing me.
That was pretty good. Okay. But you know what? That's not the trick we want to see.
What?
We have a trick. You said earlier you could make something float, didn't he, boys and girls? Yeah, we want to see that.
Yes. I did say this. I said that I can make things float in the air. What would you like to see float in the air? What about Mr. Plastic?
No, we don't want to see Mr. Plastic.
No. What about maybe these? Maybe a handkerchief?
No, I don't want to see a handkerchief.
Or let's see. My watch. I can
make
my watch.
No. You know what? I have an idea. I know what we would like to see you make float. We would like to see you make yourself float.
What?
Yeah.
No, wait. Not even the world's greatest magicians have tried such a feat as these that you are asking, Fernando.
Wait a minute, Fernando. I thought you were the world's greatest magician.
Yes. I
so
am the world's greatest
make
magician.
Float.
Fernando the Fantastico.
Then make yourself float.
I'm feeling a little extra heavy this morning. I did have a big breakfast before I showed up here.
Wait a minute.
Maybe what?
You didn't have that coat on earlier.
No, I didn't
have
this coat on.
That looks heavy.
No, it's fine.
It's not I bet if you took that coat off, you could make yourself float. Yeah.
No. Yeah. We leave the coat on me.
Well, hang on. I'll help you. Here, let me help you take it off.
No,
let me help you.
We don't need
to take it off. That is my purse.
Wait.
And that's his wallet.
I don't know how those things got there.
Security.
There's a perfectly good...
Security.
No, there's no need for security.
Yes.
No, really, there's no need. Gentlemen, no, listen. Can we talk about this? I do magic tricks for you and your children. Oh, you guys are strong. Mm. Oh, what... Okay, I know when I'm not
wanting. Wow. That is something else. Boys and girls, that's exactly like the devil. And you know what? That's exactly how you treat him. When he comes in your life and he tries to take things away from you that God's giving you, you tell him. You show him where the back door is, right? Yes. All right. How many of you are ready for some prizes? Yeah. Oh, we gave away some prizes earlier, and we're going to give away a bunch more now. Yeah, all right, I got to mix these up really good. Let me get them mixed. I think Miss Jeannie probably already did, but I'm going to mix them up even more. And I'm going to need some help. Hey, Summer, you want to come help me? Just draw one. You want to come draw a name out for me? Come here. All right, I'm going to let Summer, she's going to draw our first prize. How many of you think you won a prize today? Oh, all right, Summer, close your eyes and reach in there and dig around and pick out one. All right, she has our first winner. Our first winner of, how many of you like these? Have you ever tried a bop it? Those are fun. Our first winner of this prize is Jonathan Buchanan. All right, Jonathan, congratulations. All right, Summer, you want to stay up here and help me? You can help me with all of them. That'd be good. All right, Summer, close your eyes. Oh, look at all those Skittles. How many parents hope your child wins that? Yeah. Oh, no. Joshua Hucky. Me. No. I was not the parent hoping that. He'll have those eaten by tonight. I'm not joking. All right, Summer. Pick somebody else. The winner of the mousetrap game is Oliver Wood. Oliver, come on up. All right. What's our next? Oh, we got a magic kit here. Some of you can learn some magic better than Fernando. Who wants that magic kit? All right, Summer. Close your eyes again and pick out of there. The winner of the magic kit is, we got another Oliver Nader. Yay. Two Olivers in a row. All right, this last prize is our biggest prize. Well, look at that. It's so big, it's gonna be coming out. This is a Rip Surf skateboard, Razor skateboard, I don't know. It's something fun that moms and dads will have to help you with, huh? All right, Summer, last prize. Put one back. Yeah, drop one. There you go. All right. The winner This rip surf skateboard that moms and dads are going to love also is Blake Moss. All right, guys, be sure and come back tonight. We've got a whole new service for you guys tonight and a lot of new prizes. And then remember, what are our grand prizes tomorrow night? Thank you, Summer. I appreciate it. What is it? iPad and a Razor scooter. Thanks for coming, guys. Pastor Ron.
All right, let's give it up for the team again. Our Cornerstone Kids Zone ministry team doing a great job. Well, as Aaron said, we're doing it again tonight, 7 o'clock, and tomorrow night at 7 o'clock. I don't know if you realize this or not, but this event replaces our trunk or treat that we've done for the last 15 or 16 years. We just felt it was time for a change and a time for a new season, and we wanted to do something where we could see more of a harvest and more ministry time invested in the lives of kids. Nothing wrong with trunk or treat and giving away candy, but we want to do something a little bit more ministry-wise, and that's what we're doing tonight and tomorrow night as well. We're getting ready to receive our offering, and so if you'll go ahead and get ready, there are offering envelopes on the seat back in front of you. One of the statements that I have made so many times is that as a church, that we make no apologies for the amount of money that we spend on our youth and our children. So I said earlier, we are determined to be a next generation church. We don't want to be a church that exists for one generation, for our generation, but we're committed to passing the baton on to the next generation. A lot of things have gone on in our church let me just take a moment, and I know that Limey lost his props. But I want to give some props to our Cornerstone Kids team and our Cornerstone Children's pastors, Rodney and Aaron. Listen, they write their own curriculum. They write their own music. They record their own songs. They create their own videos. They do all their own handouts. They do this week after week after week. What happens here today is what happens every week back in our kids' zone and our other classrooms as well. And so they're a talented group of people. We invest heavily in our children. We invest heavily in our youth. Our student pastors, Dallas and Tia, do an amazing job down the hill when we hand our kids off to them. And so I cannot think of any better ground, which is good ground, than our youth and our children. So as you give this morning, I want to encourage you, and I really just felt inspired by God to do this today, that maybe if you have a need in your life, and here's a principle that we've discovered, that anytime we have a need, a significant need in our life, we need to do a step of faith, and we always invest a seed. When we have a need, we plant a seed just to get our faith out there. You can't buy the blessings of God, but we can be obedient and use our faith and get our faith out there to start believing God. And I want to ask you, would you continue to partner with us as we continue to grow our youth and children's ministry in our church? And we ask you to keep that in mind this morning as we give our tithes and offerings. Our ushers are going to come forward and wait on you. And so as they're coming, let me have a word of prayer. Father, thank you this morning for the opportunity to sow seed in what we think is great ground, our kids' ministry, our student ministry, Father, our church. And God, I pray for those today that maybe specifically are sowing a seed because of a need in their life, that they understand this is good soil to invest in, that we are committed to reaching the youth and children of our area. And God, I pray that this seed that is sown, is this offering that is received right now, is going to continue to just create the church that you want to see in this area. Father, we prayed in Jesus' name. And everybody said, come on. Amen.
Good morning, Cornerstone. I'm Ashley. We hope God did something awesome in your life today. If He did, don't forget to check in on Facebook and tell the world about it. Here's some more information on this month's outreach that we're supporting.
Hi everyone, my name is Gilbert Kitundinda, coming to you from Compassion Headquarters. I'm born from southwestern part of Uganda to a family so poor that the poor called us poor. I'm the youngest of eight and had no hope when I was young. I survived on less than $1 a day and slept on a mat on a floor. Through my local church, I got connected to Compassion. My life changed. Because of the love, care, and support from my sponsor, I was able to go to school and graduated with a bachelor's degree in information technology. Around the world, approximately 90,000 children are enrolled in compassion programs while they wait for a sponsor. This month, we are proud to partner with all of you to provide a day of care for children in need. Through the Unsponsored Children Fund, these waiting children receive nutritious meals, health assessments, and the opportunity to hear about God's love for them, among so many things. Every six check-ins this month, we provide a day of care to a child in need through compassion. Remember to check in and go good for children this month. Thank you.
Our next class starts next week and serves as your opportunity to learn more about who we are and how you can get connected here at Cornerstone. The classes are held for three consecutive Sundays at 9:30 a.m. in the community room. If you're interested in attending, please sign up at the Connection Center or online at cornerstone.tv.
Next Sunday, Men Up will be hosting an afternoon of fun at Catalyst Volleyball Court from 3 to 5 p.m. Hope to see you then.
Christmas Eve is coming soon, and our creative department is already at work with our biggest production yet. We're looking for actors and actresses who can lend their talent to the comedic and dramatic elements of our service. If that sounds like you, make sure you stop by the Connection Center and pick up an information packet for auditions, which will be held from 1 to 3 p.m. on October 9th here in the auditorium.
Thanks again for joining us today. If you're our guest today, we'd love to get to know you. Please take a moment to text the word HELLO to 405-266-2242. You can also fill out the information card in your bulletin, drop it off at our Connection Center, and one of our volunteers will give you a special gift just for being our guest. If you need prayer or if you'd just like to talk to someone, please visit our life room after service. For more information about anything here at Cornerstone, visit us online, at the Connection Center, or on social media.